What is good, guys? So I'm very excited to make this video. Probably more excited than you guys are. I don't know if you guys even look forward to watching my videos, but hey, I'm still happy that I still make them, so I don't give a F, okay? But anyway, so for those of you that have been watching my previous videos and have been keeping up with the channel, follow me on IG, know that the 350Z was unfortunately wrecked into by the previous owner, and well, I have been wanting to get a set of over fenders for a while now, and I really just haven't had the spare money because the car has been needing a countless amount of things, starting off with suspension, from cooling mods, you name it, I've had to do it to the car because the car had a plastic cracked radiator when I got it, coilovers were shot. Car was basically just a beat up 350Z. The reason why I have been investing the money into this car is because of how low the miles are. The drivetrain is absolutely solid. Yes, it's probably collapsed underneath because of how low the car was, but it drives phenomenally and the car feels amazing. That's why I've been pretty much just actually taking my time and money to invest into it and make it, you know, pretty much how I want it. And sooner or later, it's gonna be a full drift car, not a drift missile, not yet, but we're gonna be going out to the events. We've just been trying to get everything right so we only have to worry about tires, axles, and just the regular things that you would break, you know, on a long drift day. And I gotta upgrade the clutch soon because my clutch is also going out. So I know you guys have been waiting for a lot of videos, you know, of us drifting. You guys are probably wondering why. Oh, he said he's gonna go out drifting, take the car, get videos of us doing, you know, just us tandeming, running, you know, just simple little skids at the warehouses. But this car is sketched, and you don't know how many times the car has broken down on me just from doing simple warehouse drifting. Like, oh, look who's calling me today. So we're gonna be installing the over fenders. I ordered some crown carbon. I can't even pronounce the name,
bruh.
I ordered some carbon crown crafting over fenders. They're only 15 millimeter, nothing excessive, but I'm very excited because I'm gonna be cutting out the entire quarter panel on my car, and I am going to be snapping them all with some. That did not focus at all. Alright, so fenders are officially finally in. I just got back from Home Depot. Drill bits are secured. Metal grinding discs are secured. And we got a full battery. So we're ready to go. So I'm not really trying to make a tutorial, but I mean, I figured, you know, making this video, I might as well help you guys out. I'm pretty sure there's loads of videos out there already doing wide body 350Z, but hey, another one doesn't hurt. So yeah, you're gonna need some grinding disc, especially if you're going wide body. You're obviously gonna wanna cut out the rear quarter panels a bit, so when you put on the over fenders, you're obviously gonna be poking your wheels out more, meaning that where your fender used to be, that's where the wheel is basically gonna occupy. Therefore, you gotta cut out that section so your wheel could poke out more. Anyway, I'll show you guys once I start cutting it up. Picked up some Bosch drill bits to drill into the fenders and the quarter panel. And let's open these up. I'm pretty excited. Fiberglass. Definitely the passenger side because it has a little gas cap hole, and here's the driver's side. So overall, they look pretty decent. Looks like I'm probably gonna break them within a few months, but hey, they're not too bad. So, let's get to this installation.
All right, so I brought the camera here just to show you guys a bit of what's going on. So I don't mind my drawing, my sketch, but that's just a rough outline of where I'm going to be cutting it. Obviously, it doesn't really matter since it's going to be pretty hidden because you're obviously slapping the over fender on. The camera back a bit. So, just to show you guys,
this is the passenger side because I have the gas cap. So, basically, the fender. So, obviously, cut out the fender. This comes in. And then boom. Definitely need to move these around a bit. Holy crap.
Okay, well, yeah, I'm gonna need to play with these a bit because they definitely do not line up. So.
Just a rough estimate.
Around where it's gonna be. I am a bit of a perfectionist, so therefore I do want these to line up as precise as possible, but let's just get to cutting it up now, and then
so that's out the way. I'm going to get back to you guys and show you what it looks like.
Alright guys, so if you know me, I'm one that always gets to work right away, so I went ahead and just did the driver's side. Did forget to record, but don't worry. Still got the passenger side to do. My fat ass got a little bit hungry, so I went to go eat something, and I am fully energized and ready to go, so let's get to work. Right now, I'm probably just gonna mock this one up and just put in like four or two quick screws just to hold it in. And see how it's gonna sit, and then I'm gonna do that side, cut it out obviously, and then mock the fender up on that side, and after that drill out the holes and put the hardware in, and hopefully it comes out pretty good. So let's get to work. So I literally just started cutting and I was like, oh yeah, I forgot, gotta record. So obviously we're getting starting on this side, but we come on this side. So I did get it on. Definitely took more time to get it figured out, but I found the trick to it. And another thing I had to remember was that it's obviously a wide body, so it's gonna, you know, come out more, especially in the wheel well. But my biggest takeaway was for it just to line up. Therefore, it lines up perfectly right now. And now, this isn't gonna be permanent. I just put on some self-tapping screws to hold it in place so I can know exactly where I'm gonna drill out the hose. Now, I'm gonna go onto the other side and do the same. So, start cutting. Sorry guys, I haven't been recording much. I'm always one that just basically gets to work on anything I'm doing, so. I've been just trying to figure it out before I start recording, but alrighty, start cutting.
Can't find my safety glasses. I really run it up. Yeah. 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 I really run it up. Ain't been no games with this shit. I got that work up and follow the head of my wallet and told her we made for this shit. Niggas say what? Last thing I want is for this to crack. Sorry about that little interruption. My mom was like, "The hell are you doing?" And she was like, "Oh, it's good."
She noticed that I'm cleaning up. She said I was just cutting my car just because, you know, moms get that to you. Bolts down there, so that's pretty much where it's gonna sit. Now it's gotta bolt it down all around, so let's get to it.
That's it. What's left to do is drill out the holes, install the hardware, and then from the looks of it, should be good to go. So I'm obviously gonna finish. Oh damn, up close and personal. Anyway,
I'm gonna do a video of it once it's obviously finished. So I'm gonna get the hardware in, drill out the holes, and then once they're 100% on and done, I'll go ahead and make another video and show you guys the finished part.
I wonder who these are for. Yo, you need a medic? Oh my god.
Got him!
I'm not even joking.
Did he get out? Yo, this man is mean now, you see? Look at it's the karma, bro. He was making fun of me because I fucked up my ankle. And my shit.
He made fun of me for fucking up my ankle, too.
Oh, yeah, he made fun of both of us because we fucked up our ankle at, OSP? And then look at this man now.
Time to see a clapped out 350Z.
Time to see a clapped out knee 50Z.
Yeah, close the door.
What'd you do?
I don't know, yeah, I'm gonna get x-ray. Yo.
Can you even move your leg?
Bro, look, I can stand on it, but, and I can, like...
But you can't walk on it.
I can go
it.
Like this, but I can't lift it. I can't lift it up. It's like...
The yeah, you're like me. It's like when you put pressure, you try to lift it up or move it. Ryan, ready to go rain drifting?
Yo, can you adjust my coilovers real quick?
Yes. Bye, Felicia.
Yeah, stand.
What's up, guys? So, I just finally got the car on the floor. Both the fenders are on. Well, except this side because, well, we got this going on.
So, I drilled out the holes the size I needed to get the, let me see if I can. So, that little rib nut right there goes inside the fender, obviously, and then it expands as it gets tightened with a nut that locks onto it, and then you basically put the fenders on, and you tighten them down with the hardware, and it hopefully will clean it all up, but... We're dealing with. Sheesh. Oh, yeah, here's the other sides. Other sides. Other side. Comparison. I love the way it came out. It looks super good with the wheels. Because they're pretty wide, but obviously I'm going to get this car painted. And. I am going to put a spacer on for the meantime, but for now, this should work, so.
Alright, so I actually found this pretty cool. So I did order, like I said, the dress-up hardware, but what I did not know was the nut that goes inside the fender were rivet nuts. What does that mean?
basically pop them inside the fender. Like this. Feel like a little bullet shell, whatever you want to compare that to. And basically there's threads at the end of it, so what you do is they sell this kit that goes through. It's basically a long bolt nut and a grappling washer, I guess you could call it, because, you know, grapples onto it. But I found this pretty sick because I did not know what the hell these were, but I actually had to look up to see how the hell these worked. And, well, I actually built my own little DIY kit to go ahead and get these in. And like I said, you just go to Home Depot. My specific size, I got these on Amazon. It was a M5 by 0.8 metric, not standard. And get your little washer, grapple washer, you can call it. Just a nut. Bolt, make sure the bolt has a hexagon end so you can be able to put a wrench or a ratchet on it. Makes it 10 times easier. But this is how they come out. So I got two in so far. Finally got the hang of it down. So, oh, there's already one here. Okay, so right there, as you can see, this one's in. That is not going anywhere. This one's in there as well. It's not going anywhere either. So like I said, the fender goes on. These obviously go over it with the truss up washer. Tighten that down and kit should be on. So I'm gonna get the rest of them on. Like I said, it's already late, but I really want to get this done, just see how it looks. I should stop soon because it don't work the same when you're tired, but who cares? Let's get this done. All right, guys, so here's the final and finished product. So I've got them all tapped in. The bolt did not last me. I stretched them all out, so I'm gonna just have to buy some more tomorrow to do the other side. But this is basically how they're supposed to come out. And overall, I'm super happy with the outcome of this. Like, it looks very nice. I'll definitely get the other side finished earlier tomorrow, because today I basically wasted the whole day waiting on FedEx to drop these off. But extremely satisfied with the outcome of them. Fitment, it's all right, but like I said, the main reason was to obviously clean up the fenders, because that side was crashed into, and so I could remove all my camber and run zero camber. Now we have a wide body kit, so therefore I could run zero camber without any clearance issues. And I'll definitely get some more videos of this tomorrow in the daylight so you guys can see how it looks outside. But absolutely in love with the way this came out. So catch you guys tomorrow. What's up, guys? Welcome back. This is day two. So I woke up around 7:30 today, went to the gym, got my daily routine out the way, you know, gonna chug down a bang. But I finally brought the car out as well. And well, let me just show you guys a little bit of what's going on and how it looks. So here she is. That's the only part I don't like on this side, but what am I gonna do about it? Because this is the side that unfortunately did get wrecked into, so it does flare out a bit more, but that's okay, because covered up the quarter panel is how I wanted, and it looks pretty good for what it is, so not too bad. But here's the other side. Install the hardware. I'm gonna go buy a rivet gun to finish this side. Um, because I actually ended up stripping all of my bolts. You see that nut? Yeah, well, it does come off, but it got stretched out and can't use it. And I'm tired of using a wrench with the small 8mm ratchet just to be able to get it to basically expand the rivet on the inside of the fender so it could obviously bolt on. Wow, these fenders actually look really good. But we have a much bigger issue than getting that done, because this morning my idiot self decided to try to test fit on some spacers to see how it would look, and I stripped one of the lugs, and now the entire stud is just spinning and I can't get the lug off. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to get that off and then obviously order some new lug studs. But I mean, it gives me the opportunity to go with the ARP in the rear, so that way we can be able to mount wheels on and off, putting up basically on any size spacer without having to use the studs on the spacers, because I did do it on my S14. Trust me guys, you switch wheels around a lot like me, and you always want basically just putting on different size spacers. Save yourself the hassle and get ARP studs, because they're obviously like, I don't know what the size of regular stud is, but they're basically double the size of the factory studs. So when you put them in, they obviously poke out way more than the factory ones, and they're reinforced, so you have less of a possibility of stripping them and stretching them out, of course breaking them. I've never, thank God, you know, fingers crossed, broke a stud, and let's hope I don't. But anyway, I am gonna order those, like I said, because that, for example, a 1-inch spacer, let's say you're gonna use your regular studs, you basically have to bolt these down using the studs on there already, and then probably have to trim off an excess in case they poke out a bit, and then obviously use the studs on the spacer to mount your wheels. With ARPs, you could take out these extra lugs. Why? Because they poke out all the way and they still reach your wheels, and you can still tighten them down. So yeah, they're very convenient. So hopefully we get that off. But I'm gonna go out to Northern Tools because that's where I found the rivet gun, and it's only $25, so I figured might as well save myself the hassle and just pick up the gun in case I ever need it again in the future. Because I do plan on going wide body in the front, but I just haven't decided whether I want to get the entire fender or just potentially get overs as well. So we'll see, but catch you guys in a bit. Alrighty, so we picked up the rivet gun. Didn't record because I just came straight home. The only issue with this is that they are standard sizes and the bolts aren't metric, so hopefully we can manage to make this work. But if not, I'll figure something out and get it done. But let's get to it and let's see if we could be able to get that side, well, the hardware on that side. Gotta drill out the holes, but catch you guys. All right, so just to show you guys a bit of how it works. So basically, you obviously need your drill. Don't mind my broken battery pack. Metal drill bit, and you want to outline all your holes first, obviously, so you know exactly where you need to drill so you can bolt down the fenders evenly. But I already did that, so that's out the way. I already got most of the backside drilled out, so I figured I'd show you guys how the little rivet nuts work. And I'm gonna do this one, and I chose this hard just because, but let's get it. So you just want to drill it out just like so. Okay, that's that. And then usually, at least because of the other side, I have to take a bit of a bigger drill bit and open up that hole a little bit more. And then what you want to do is, don't mind my broken booty jeans. Where's it going? Here it is. Oh, never mind, I already have one. There we go. So this is your rivet gun. You see a well nut right there? You put it in. In this case, this is why I need to drill out the hole a little bit more.
That's in. And then, the cool thing about this, let me see if I can get this camera. It's like any rivet gun. You basically just take it, and you tighten it right there, until pretty much tighten all the way. And you want to take it, squeeze it. What that does is it tightens that well nut inside your fender well. So then what you do is take this out. And then boom, that's inside. And all you do is put the fender on, take up your hardware, take up your tape. I don't have my vocabulary, I don't know what the hell I'm saying sometimes, but it's okay. Let's put this right here on the table. Take your dress-up hardware like that. This obviously goes on top of your fender. Goes on like that. And then you basically just tighten it down. And that tightens your fenders on. Well, your old fenders. So I have about 12 more to do. Oh no, actually, I lied. I have like 4. So I'm gonna finish these. Put all the well nuts in. And then put the fenders on. And I'll get back to you guys once that's done. And I'll show you the finished product. Alright guys, so I just finished up the driver's side. Here's the final finished product. This side definitely was, of course, much harder than the other side. There's always gonna be that one side that's harder, but whatever. So basically, you can tell they're Allen bolts right here. I had to use a longer bolt because the car was wrecked into, therefore this is crushed in some more, but I was able to put a bolt on there. Right here, this one didn't tighten down all the way. Basically the rivet nut came loose and it started spinning on the inside, so it's a bit loose, but the rest, they went fairly good. Not too bad about it. It came up better than what I was expecting it to. Here's the other side. So shout out to Northern Tools because they sold me a rivet gun that got 11 out of 12 finished. I snapped it on the last one. So I'm gonna go return and just get a new one because I definitely feel like I'm gonna have to redo this process some other time because, like I said, there's spots that I messed up on and I definitely wanna fix them. But for now, it looks good. I mean, the fenders are on, obviously, you know, from the looks of it, they're not going anywhere. So that's all that matters. But I'm gonna go out to Northern Tools and then I'll bring you guys along with me and I'll just show you guys the car from the outside and an open lot so you guys can get a good overview of it and how they came out. So I'll see you in a bit. Okay guys, so here we are. This is the final finished product. Absolutely in love with the way these came out. Fitment definitely was not an issue. The only issues I had was because the car was wrecked into by the previous owner, as I mentioned before, but that's obviously nothing to do with the fenders. Overall installation, I'd say a 9 out of 10. Definitely had to maneuver it a bit, get it to line up each corner. So then you could basically see how the fender falls into place. Because you got to remember, it's wide, so it's not going to arc exactly to line up with the factory fenders. But that's how we're looking. Remind me, I'm putting gas. So another thing that I realized, that the gas cap, it was cut out perfect. It wasn't an issue opening that up. But overall, came out decently good. Head back home. I'm gonna get to see if I figure out a way to remove the stripped out lug stud so I can obviously be able to take that off. And as you can tell, so you guys can see how pretty crashed into this thing got. So this is where your factory fender would probably come out to.
As you can see, that whole section right there is pretty much just missing. And I know it's because on the other side, it flushed onto the fender evenly around all these edges. There was no gap on the other side, and obviously, you guys can see it got hit pretty hard, so. But that's the reason why I got him, to cover that up, but that's the end for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed that. And, well, catch you guys on the next one.